So today I'm gonna show you how to go ahead and set up your most important overlays inside of Streamlabs, like you're starting soon, your countdown, your be right back, your stream offline, and your gameplay scene inside of Streamlabs. So if you don't have Streamlabs desktop installed, I'll put a link in the description of this video. When you first open it up, you're gonna see scenes on the left and sources here on the right. So scenes are gonna be just that, the scenes that you're gonna be switching to when you're streaming, like you're starting soon, your be right back, etc. And then your sources are gonna be the things included in those scenes, like your overlays. So let's go ahead and set up all of our scenes first. So by default, you'll have this one named scene. We'll right click, we'll click rename, and we'll go ahead and name this starting soon. We'll press done. And first we'll set up all our scenes, then we'll start filling it in the sources. So the next one we're gonna go ahead and add here is gonna be our countdown timer. Press done. Then we're gonna add another one and we're gonna name this here, be right back. Press done. We're gonna add another one here as well. We're gonna name this here, stream offline. We'll press done here. And then we're gonna go ahead and add here our gameplay as well and click done. So now that we have our most important scenes here, we now can go ahead and start filling them with our overlays. Now for this video, I'm gonna go ahead and utilize overlays from streamdesigns.com. They have tons of animated overlays you can go ahead and choose from. For this example, I'm gonna go ahead and utilize the Pixel World Pack. And you can see that the Pixel World Pack is gonna give us everything that we need to make our stream look professional, from our countdown timer to our starting soon, to our be right back, to our stream offline, to our just chatting. So you can go ahead and I'll put a link in the description of this video for Stream Designs. And then I'm also going to go ahead and get a countdown timer. So the countdown timer is not included inside of the package. So I'm going to go ahead and get the matching countdown timer for Pixel World that we're going to utilize here today. So once you go ahead and have your overlay selected, we'll come back here to Streamlabs. We'll come to sources, hit this little plus icon. And now we're gonna have two options here. If you're utilizing animated overlays, you're gonna want to use media file. If you're using static overlays, you're gonna want to select image. Because these overlays are animated, I'm gonna select media file. I'm gonna click add source, and I'm gonna name this start. I'm gonna press add source. And now this is gonna go ahead and ask you to locate the file that you went ahead and downloaded from Stream Design. So I'm gonna click browse. That's gonna go ahead and open up my desktop. And here, wherever you downloaded your Stream Designs file is gonna come in a zip file first. So if you're on Windows, you're gonna wanna right click and select extract. And that's gonna give you a folder just like this. And if you're on Mac, you're gonna want to double click the zip file and it's gonna give you a folder just like this. Once you have the folder, then you'll be able to open it up and then select overlay screens. And then you'll see here that we have now our starting soon. Press open. I am gonna want this to be able to loop. And then I'm gonna hit close. And now you can see here that we have our starting soon. So now I'm gonna go ahead and lock that so it doesn't move. And now we can go ahead and add in our countdown timer. So we're gonna follow the same process, hit this little plus icon. We're gonna select media file. We're gonna hit add source. We're gonna click here, add new source instead. And I'm gonna name this timer, add source, locate file. I'm gonna hit browse. And again, remember this is gonna be separate from the pack. So you'll get a second zip file. So double click on it or go ahead and extract it. You'll get a folder just like this. And now here we have our countdown timer. And this I do not want to loop because once the timer finishes, I want it to go to the next scene. So you have that there. So now we have our countdown timer. So the next one we're gonna go ahead and add is our be right back. So again, we'll come to this little plus icon. We'll hit media file, add source, add new one. And this one I like to call BRB, add source. And then we'll locate that file again. And that's gonna be located inside of your package. And it's gonna be on their overlay screens. And then you'll see here, that's gonna be right back. We'll press okay. And we do want this to loop. Now, this is a great scene to be able to utilize if you have to go to the restroom, if you have to step away. That way your viewers have something to watch and they're not looking at an empty chair or a black screen. So now that we have that in place, we'll lock that as well. And then we'll come here to our stream offline. We'll hit this little plus icon. We're gonna go to media file again, add new source, and then we'll name this offline, add source. And then we'll locate the file again that comes inside of your pack. So here you have it here, and this is gonna be the ending soon. We'll open this up. I do want this to be able to loop, hit close. And this is gonna be the scene that you would switch to when you're getting ready to wrap up your stream. That way they have something to see, the music's still playing, you're still able to talk and say your final goodbyes before ending the stream. So now you'll see here that now we have our gameplay. This is gonna be the scene that you're gonna spend the most time in. This is the one that requires to have your camera, to have your chat, to have your alerts, to have your stream labels, everything that you need to make this scene look professional. And when you come here and you click on this little plus icon for media, and select media files, add source. We'll name this here game. You'll press add source, locate file, and then you're gonna see here that now you're gonna have your overlay bar. You're going to go ahead and have your webcam overlays, and you're gonna have your alert. So to be able to go ahead and set up your gameplay scene, I want you to go ahead and watch this video right here where I walk you step-by-step on how to do just that inside of Streamlabs. I'll see you guys in the next video.